Now step I forth to whip hypocrisy. Ah, good my liege, I pray thee pardon me. Good heart, what grace hast thou thus to approve these worms for loving that art most in love? Your eyes debate no coaches in your tears. There's no certain princess that appears. You'll not be perjured. It's a hateful thing. Shh. None but minstrels like insanity. But are you not ashamed? Nay, are you not? All three of you, to be thus much overshot. You found his moat, the king his moat did see, but I, a beam, do find in each of the three. Oh, what a scene of foolery have I seen, of sighs, of groans, of sorrow, and of teen. Oh, me, oh, with what strict patience have I sat to see a king transformed into a gnat. To see great Hercules whipping a gig, and profound Solomon to tune a jig, and Nestor playing at pushpins with the boys. Critic Timon, laugh at idle toys. Where lies thy grief? Tell me, good domain, and gentle Longville, where lies thy pain? And where's my lieges? All about the breast. A coddle ho! What a rogue and peasant slave am I. Is it not monstrous that this player here, but in a fiction and a dream of passion, could force his soul so to his own conceit, that from her working all his visage, wand, tears in his eyes, distraction and aspect, a broken voice, his whole function suiting, reforms to his conceit, and for nothing. For Hecuba, what's heck out of a him or he to Hecuba that he should weep for? What would he do? Had he the motive or the cue for passion that I have? He would drown the stage in tears. Cleave the general ear of horrid speech. Make mad the guilty, appall the free, confound the ignorant, and maze indeed the very faculties of eyes and ears. Can I? Dull, muddy metal rascal peak. But John dreams, unpregnant of my cause, and can say nothing. No. Not for a king, upon whose property and most dear life a damn defeat was made. Am I a coward?